We have heard that 500,000 children have died. I mean, that's more children than died in Hiroshima. And you know, is the price worth it?
I think this is a very hard choice, but the price, we think the price is worth it.
Well documented that large numbers of al-Qaeda, they were called the Mujahideen back then, came to Bosnia and Kosovo to fight the Serbs in what they called their European Jihad. Therefore, the U.S. and NATO were supporting al-Qaeda in the Balkans while they were simultaneously bombing our embassies in Kenya and Tanzania. And according to this administration, plotting 9/11. Can you comment on this?
Well, it's wrong, but anyway, let me just say this, is that I think...
It's documented.
Really?
And
okay.
My members of my family were murdered by Mujahideen.
Right. Let me explain the issue. I was born in Czechoslovakia. My father was ambassador to Yugoslavia. And so this is one part of the world that I am very familiar with, and also the background of this particular war. I think it is a tragedy of what happened in the Balkans and the policies of Milosevic, which were to ethnically cleanse the Kosovars. The Balkans is a very complicated place where there were large populations of Muslims as well as of Christians, both Orthodox and Catholic. And this is what goes back to the earlier question here about some of the religious background of some of the problems. The Serbs were ethnically cleansing the Kosovars. They went in there and deliberately tried to stop the fact that Kosovars could go to their own schools. They pillaged the place.
Was that after thousands of Mujahideen from Afghanistan came to fight them?
Before. And I think that there
they
were...
They came in the 90s in Bosnia. It's a canned answer. I don't believe you.
On November 2nd of this last year, less than 2 months before she was assassinated, former Prime Minister Benazir Bhutto was asked by reporter Sir David Frost about a letter that she had sent to Pakistani dictator Pervez Musharraf. And the letter outlined who she believed should be investigated in the event of her assassination. There was an assassination attempt on her in October, killed about 158 people, I believe. And she mentioned in the interview that there were multiple people that she felt could be involved with her assassination attempt, but it was more important to get to who was financing these people, who was behind the financing of it. And one of the things that she said, and I actually have this on recording right here, I'd like to play it real quick so the people here in the audience know it is. And she said that a key figure in her security, a former military officer in Pakistan, had dealings with, among other, Omar Sheikh, who was the man who murdered Osama bin Laden.
I think I understand. You're wondering how she got murdered. I don't think that's going to work. But let me just say the following thing.
Audience very briefly was who Omar Sheikh was. In 1999, Indian Airlines Flight 814 was hijacked by Pakistan International. Sorry, you didn't ask the question. The question that I have is that Omar Sheikh is the man that wired $100,000 to Mohammed Atta, the lead hijacker. He was ordered to wire the money to Mohammed Atta from General Mahmoud Ahmad, who's a Pakistani intelligence, who's...
Okay.
What's your question?
I think that...
My question, please, if you'll let me finish. Seems very likely that Osama bin Laden is no longer alive. My mother died this past year. hazard of renal failure. I know that if you're running blood from a kidney machine for 10 days, you don't live. Based on all the huge amounts of evidence, don't you feel that an investigation is warranted in the very least to have Omar Sheikh, the man who Benazir Bhutto said murdered Osama bin Laden, into question since he is still alive in Pakistani custody? That is my question.
Okay, I do believe that there needs to be an investigation of Benazir Bhutto's assassination. And I think that it should be an international investigation and that we need the answers on it. There have been some various things that have recently come out of Pakistan saying that this was some group, but there are those who think that Pervez Musharraf and various people had something to do with it. I don't know what the answers are, but I do think that it requires